Morning. Welcome again to Geelong's Gym's online class of yoga this morning. We've been on the previous classes in the last few weeks. It'll be similar. I try to keep the asanas, the poses similar so you can get used to them, but there's always some changes that I put in there. So once again, I'll do that again this week. Something different to try. Let's begin. Begin just coming to standing at the top of your mat. Standing up nice and tall. Coming to your breath. And inhale through your nose. Open your mouth. Exhale. Close your mouth. Sound between your ears. Listening to that. A little bit of restriction in the throat. Correct the sound, breath, noise. Drawing your lower abdomen in slightly up. Maybe you feel your pelvic floor, there's a slight lift there. That, along with your gaze, will bring you inwards internally. It helps quieten the mind rather than darting around thinking about what's going to happen during the day. Play your practice slowly. Any modifications you need or want. Rest and rejoin when you choose. Wherever you are, take an exhale. Inhale, raise your hands, raise your thumb. Exhale, fold forward into this full fold, Uttanasana, hands as you take in and look forward. On the inhale, rise halfway, extend your heart forward, look forward. Exhale, place your hands on the floor. The first one, you're going to walk a step back and place your knees, thighs, belly on the floor. Engage your quads and belly, knees lift off the ground. Inhale, lift the Bhujangasana, this cobra pose. Then exhale, knees back to the floor. Hips and heels into a down dog and adjust your feet, adjust your hands. That's a nice, easy way to start. Spread your fingers, spread your toes. Just three more breaths here. Broaden your shoulders. You can have your knees bent to take pressure off your lower back or relaxing your heels towards the floor. Another breath here. Inhale. Exhale, prepare to come top of the mat. You can bend your knees, look forward. Inhale, walk, step, maybe you jump in time. Exhale, fold. Inhale, rise, reaching your hands to the ceiling, gaze to your thumbs. And exhale, back to Samasthiti. A couple of times. Inhale, Uttanasana, gaze to the thumbs. Inhale, finishes. Exhale, fold forward. Hands down, maybe to the floor. Inhale, this heart lift, Ardha Uttanasana. Send your heart forward. And exhale, walk, step, or jump back to Chaturanga, this push-up position, or the previous asana. Inhale, up dog if you're in Chaturanga, knees are off the ground, and exhale into downward facing dog. Half a breath to settle yourself here. Now some quietness with your breath, listening to your breath. Your lower abdomen slightly drawn in, and your gaze down the bridge of your nose. Two more breaths here. Exhale for five, bend knees, look forward. Inhale, walk, step, in your own time, jump into your jumper, floating. Exhale, fold. Inhale, rise, reach your hands to the ceiling, gaze to your thumbs. And exhale, Samasthiti. One more time. Inhale, Uttanasana.
Love and honor the places you've been.
Exhale, Uttanasana.
Purify the self as a seat of action, all paths lead within.
Inhale, Ardha Uttanasana.
Om Shanti.
Exhale, Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhale, Uttamukha Savasana. Upper space yourself. Exhale, Ardha Mukha. Downward facing. Five breaths. So listen to the breath, gaze down with your nose. Lower abdomen drawing. Three, two more breaths. On your exhale, prepare, look forward, bend knees perhaps. Inhale, walk, step, float to the top of your mat, connect. Exhale, fold. Inhale, raise hands, ceiling, engage the thumb. And exhale, Samasthiti. do another scarabee. Then knees, which is chair position, fierce pose, uttanasana. On the exhale, back to uttanasana. Inhale, slightly rise to Ardha Uttanasana. Uplift. Exhale, Chaturanga Nadasana. Inhale, Uddha Mukha Savasana, upward facing dog. Exhale, Ardha, downward facing. On your left heel in. Inhale, step your right foot forward. Raise arms, warrior one, left foot forward. Exhale, hands back to the floor. Step back, Chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Okay, right heel, step left foot. Ground right heel, right heel forward. Raise arms. Warrior, exhale. Chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Just start to focus on the breath. Engage. Shoulders, turn and rotate the thighs. Inhale, exhale, prepare to come top of your mat. Inhale, come top of your mat as you length. Exhale, fold. Inhale, bend the knees, come into Uttanasana. And exhale, Samasthiti. One more, inhale, Uttanasana. Exhale, Uttanasana. Inhale, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhaling, Chaturanga Nadasana. Inhale, Uddha Mukha Savasana. Exhale, Ardha Mukha, downward facing. Virabhadrasana Warrior, foot right side. Inhale, step right foot, ground left heel, back up. Exhale, back to Chaturanga. Uddha Mukha Savasana, and inhale. Ardha Mukha Savasana, downward dog, but exhale. Inhale, left foot steps, right heel ground, right arm. Exhale, Chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. So adjust perhaps the hands and the feet. And lengthen the front of your body. Relaxing of the heels towards the floor. Internally rotate your thighs. Just a few more breaths. On exhale, prepare. Look forward. Inhale. On top of the mat. If you're listening. Look forward. Exhale, fold.
Let me see.
Bend knees on the inhale.
We all make mistakes.
Uttanasana.
Friends, can you forgive the place?
And exhale, Samasthiti. Take a step on the top of your mat. Come into Uttanasana. Make your hands apart, fingers together, perhaps. Evenness between the balls of your feet and your heels. Excuse me. It looks like a Kalvananda, but feel the arch in your lumbar spine. Two more breaths. Four. Inhale. Exhale, folding forward, hands to the four fingers wide spread. A customer, so perhaps just rise onto the balls of your feet and weight on your hands. If available, knees will take your triceps. If available, knees into your armpits. Look forward, raise legs. Straight arms, perhaps. Belly in, gaze forward. You're up, three more breaths. Inhale, exhale. Exhale for four, one more breath, inhale, one exhale, lower your feet, walk, step, jump back to Chaturanga, inhale for upward facing, exhale for down dog, okay, left heel, inhale, step your right foot forward, raise arms, warrior one, you're going to hold here for five breaths, so you're holding, then grounding that rear leg, outside edge, and that left hip forward, rear hip. Gaze perhaps to your thumbs are forward.
Can you forgive the place that generates
hate? Belly in. Last breath.
Take the grace.
Exhale for five. Inhale, wind your stance. And exhale, knee towards your little toe of the front leg. Draw your spine back over your hips. Warrior two. Four more breaths. Belly in, relax shoulders. Up three. Two more breaths. There's a little feeling of the opening hips here slightly. Up for five. On your inhale, straighten up right leg. Maybe shorten the stance, cup the Trikonasana. So reach out. And place the hand onto your thigh, shin, ankle, toe, hand open perhaps. And dump your weight into the hand, try and engage torso. Extend your heart forward and turn your heart to the ceiling. Two, three more breaths. You're holding your toe, pull up on the toe, or your shin, or your hand open. Another breath here. Cool. Inhale. Exhale, down to your balance. Inhale, rise. Short stance. Widen your stance. Extend side angle pose. Bend the front knee, bring your elbow onto your knee. Extend your hand to the ceiling. Broaden your, open your shoulders and reach away from that rear leg if available. Hand on the floor, fingertips, or perhaps a block. Have a block. Turn your heart up to the ceiling. Look under your armpit as well as your hand. Strong rear leg. Four, one more breath, inhale. On exhale, look down. Place both hands either side of the front foot, raise your rear heel. Slide your rear leg up a third. Place your right hand forward of your right foot and slightly to your right, your left hand onto your hip. Ardha Chandrasana. On inhale, engage both legs. Turn that left hip up to the ceiling. Fingertips is ideal for the right hand here. Perhaps you raise that left hand. Look up at the left hand perhaps. Engage rear leg. Flex your foot to the side. From perspective at the front. Your heel extending back to wall behind you. Your heart forward. One more breath. On your following exhale, lower that left hand. Square your hips and lower that left hip. Left leg still up, toes pointing towards the floor. On your inhale, raise your right hand. Place it onto the small of your back, or perhaps to the ceiling. Rotating version of this pose. Turn your heart up to the ceiling. Maybe you look up at that hand. Keep that leg up, strong rear leg. Three, two more breaths. Inhale. Reach your heart forward, turn your heart up to the ceiling. On your following exhale, lower that hand. Bend the front leg and step long back into a lunge. Keep the front leg bent. Inhale, rise. Place your hands behind your back. Open your chest. Come to a bound warrior as you exhale. Forward fold. Reach your heart forward. Three more breaths. Heart breath. Inhale. Exhale. Release your hands to the floor. Lower your rear knee to the floor. Rise tall. Raise your left hand. Exhale. Bring your left elbow on the outside of your right knee. Hands in prayer position. Turn your heart to the ceiling. That can be enough. Perhaps you bring that hand to the floor. Perhaps you extend the heel. Raise heel on the ground perhaps. Perhaps this rotating extended side angle pose. Or stay here for leg up or knee down. Perhaps you look up over that right shoulder. With your hands extended towards the head. A couple more breaths. When you're following exhale, look down, place both hands either side of that front foot and step back to Chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Warrior one, left side. Tip left foot forward. Ground right heel. All that on this side. Draw your shoulders. Reach hands up. Bring it apart. Put your thumbs. Belly in. Two more breaths. Exhaling for five. Inhale, open. So as you open your hips, you widen the stance that ankle opening, and lean towards your little toe. Gaze middle finger of that left hand in front.
Yes.
Good. Bring your breath. Last breath. Inhale. Exhale, moving to Tadasana. Inhale, straighten the front leg, shorten the stance. Exhale, reach, hand, thigh, shin, ankle, toe. Bend your heart up to the ceiling. Extend your heart forward. Shoulders broaden. Spring away. Four, on the breath. Exhale, perhaps you look down. Inhale, rise, relax. Extend side close, widen your stance. Exhale, elbow and knee, if that's where you were, hand to the ceiling or extending. There's a broadening shoulder blades away from each other. Just bring your palm down rather than just your wrist. And a reach, extend side close, extend your heart up. Look under the armpits, look towards the hand. Couple breaths. Exhale for five, look down, place both hands to the side of the front foot. Slide your leg up on the inhale. Left hand forward, slide the left, right hand on hip. Arch and muscle, inhale. And keep hip to the ceiling, hip to the ceiling, towards the floor, towards the screen, or perhaps up towards your hand. Both legs are strong. Belly, heart forward and turned up. Kadavita variation, rotating variation. Exhale, lower that raised hand, right hand. Square your hips, so point the toe of the raised leg to the floor. Inhale, raise your right hand. Heart forward. Extend your heart to the ceiling. Maybe look up the hand. Extend the heel back to the wall behind you. Strong legs. A lot bend in the front leg, perhaps while struggling to balance. One more breath. Inhale. And exhale, lower your hand. Bend the front leg, step back into a lunge. Keep the front leg bent. Inhale, rise. And place your fingers. And exhale, up to bear bar. Using smoothie today. Two more breath. Inhale. On your exhale, release your hands to the floor. Gently lower your knee to the floor. Raise your right hand. Exhale. Elbow to the outside of your knee. Palms together. Same variation to the other side. So if you did just this variation, do that here. If you straighten your leg and open your arms. Go there. Three more breaths. Perhaps you look up your shoulder. Extend your heart forward. Elbow towards the floor if your hands are touching the floor. Last breath. On exhale, release your hands to the floor. Step back to Chaturanga. Inhale to up dog. Exhale to down dog. Lower your knees. And sit onto your heels. So here, we do those dolphin poses on our elbows, preparing us for Pinchavirasana, elbow forearm stand. It's about opening the armpits. So just give you an example, we'll work towards coming here, but it's about opening your shoulders over your elbows rather than place here, bending your arch. So those that do that, make sure that you're bringing those shoulders over your elbows. The rest, we're going to do what we did in the last few weeks. You'll be tucking your toes under, raising one leg, and make sure they're square. Just like last week. So inhale, come into your hands and knees. Lower your elbows to the floor. Forearms, you know, parallel if they can. Tuck your toes under, take an inhale. Exhale, lift hips to the ceiling. Open your armpits. Walk your feet towards your elbows. Raise right leg. Point toe. Straight leg. Push into your forearms and hand for two. Three, two more breaths. Little break coming up just after the next 5 breaths. Inhale, exhale, lower down. Inhale, raise the other leg, straight leg. The hip of the raised leg down to the floor. Open your armpits. Pincher, front hold. Use the wall if you're there. Three, two more breaths. Open your armpits, open chest. Strong pose. Last breath, inhale, lift. Exhale, lower, come to child's pose. Lower your knees. Hips on heels, come to your breath. It's a nice warm up to create heat. Prepare you for the rest of the practice. Single breaths. Observe the belly lightly drawn in. Upper belly relaxed with the ribs, chest, and shoulder blades. On your inhale, rise onto your hands and knees. Tuck your toes under. Exhale to a down dog. Walking your hands towards your feet. Coming up, full fold. So maybe you hold your elbows, you reach your toes, Padmasana. Peace fingers or pistol grip, toes, inhale lengthen, and exhale fold, some weight forward into the balls of your feet, your shoulders towards your hips, your heart lengthen forward, or releasing your elbows towards the floor. One breath. You're holding your elbows, swap them round, grab the opposite grip, from your toes or ankle, chin, calves, inhale, rise. Go deeper perhaps put a Hastasana where the hands under your feet, close the crease of your wrists, and exhale, elbows slightly out, shoulders to hips. Jack your sitting bones up to the ceiling, away from your knees, away from your ankles. Knees can be bent to take pressure off the lower back. Straight shoulders. A light draw of that upper trapezium there behind your heart towards your hips rather than the shoulders towards your ears. One breath. You're holding your elbows, exhale, release your hands. Release your hands from the floor and just rise so you can see the screen. A little simple exercise, yet hard. Bring your hands on the floor, elbows, so just in here, you try and raise your hip, so your right hip first, and bring your toes up towards your wrist, so then inhale, lift, and toes towards your wrist. 5 breaths, the seam, so face, just look here again, just come down, so often it's people can bend and lift, I want to hold here. I want you to lift the leg with your hip, so it's all core strength, belly, thigh, torso. So it's a lift up the hip, and toes, so thigh to belly. 4 more breaths. Inhale up. Exhale. There, inhale. Exhale. Exhale. 3 more breaths. Lift the hip. Maybe on blocks with your hand, your fingertips. Do the best you can. Maybe your knees a bit. Exhale, lower them down. Upper side, once again, you can look here. So it's a lift of the hip, toes to wrist, core strength lifting up, hands pushing into the floor. 5 breaths. 1, 4 breaths. 2, lift. 3, pushing to the floor, your hands. 4, 1 more breath. Exhale, lowering down, bend your knees, gently. Rolling yourself up and standing. Another balance. Raise your hands to the ceiling. Hold your feet forward or up to your thumbs. belly in, strong legs, reaching for ceiling. One more breath. Exhale, lowering the heels, lowering the hands. Keep your right foot forward, or so you can see the screen. Positive Padmasana, or straddle forward folds. That's what it is, your feet parallel to each other. Inhale, raise your hands to the ceiling, gaze at the thumbs. And exhale, fold at your hips. Maybe hands on thighs, maybe onto blocks, or the floor, or perhaps fingertips aligned at the toes. Inhale, lengthen. And exhale, forward fold. On the first one, the elbows inside in line with your wrists and shoulders. There's an A, C and D today. Belly in. And jacking of the sitting bones to the ceiling. Your heart forward. Your pubic bone away from your heart. Inhale, rise halfway. Exhale, release your hands to your waist. Inhale, rise. Reach your hands to the ceiling. Go to your thumbs. Exhale, bring your hands behind your back. Interlace your fingers. Extend your arms. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Outside edge of your feet, parallel to each other. Belly drawn in. Some weight forward of the heels towards the balls of your feet. One more breath. Exhale, five. Bend knees perhaps. Inhale, rise. And exhale, raise your hands to the waist. Position D. Inhale, lift up to the ceiling. Exhale, fold. Maybe your hands onto your thighs, shins, ankles. If available, twist fingers wrap around your toes. Inhale, lengthen here. Torso long, hips bone back, heart forward. And exhale. As you jack your sitting bones to the ceiling, your heart lower. Elbows out. Exhale for two. One more breath. Inhale. Exhale, five. Inhale, rise. Have your blocks handy shortly. Even if you stop the last a wide-legged forward fold. So widen your feet as comfortable as possible. Instead of folding down, think of your groin towards the floor. Perhaps your elbows to the floor, but reach your heart forward for five breaths. Still straight down, crown your head forward. Shoulders to your hips, three. One more breath, inhale, exhale, inhale, rise. Have your blocks in front of you, have blocks. Put your blocks in front of you, don't have blocks. Come into Hanumanasana. So inhale, you're going to walk your hands to your rear leg, most likely your left leg. And come back, lower the knee to the ground. Have blocks handy, so we're going to work on the rear leg. So often in splits, people come down and they open the hips. I want you to square that rear leg forward. So if you're looking over your left leg, your right hip forward. Option is to come into your monkey pose, Hanumanasana. You can come into baby monkey, which is a lunge, and you bend the front leg. And same with the block, it's that rear hip forward. Then here, blocks, perhaps. You raise your torso up, lay your fingertips on the ground. That's enough for today. Or you're up high, or perhaps even higher. Not too concerned about the rear leg position today. Roll that rear hip forward. One more breath, inhale. On your exhale, fold forward, just a couple breaths over the front leg. Use your blocks. And walking your hands back to the front. Turn around, prepare for Hanumanasana on the other side. Once again, the blocks next to you, your height that you choose. Inhale, working on that rear Relay. Front set. Exhale. Knee hip forward. So left hip most likely. Heart up. Maybe you're on tall blocks. Maybe you're higher. Or maybe you've got the front leg bent. Lengthen that relay. Two more breaths. Inhale. Exhale. In time, come lower and lower. But without opening the hips. One more breath. Left hip forward. Exhale. You fold over. Release your block. Walk your hands back to center. Then come to seated. Come to sit your own way, or perhaps like last week, in your favourite hand. Back. Lower down. Seated position. That's wide. Good position to Konasana. Yeah, maybe you'd like to have a blanket or a prop under your sitting bones to create a tallness here. So sternum, heart up, pubic bone down. Take a breath and exhale, fold. A centimetre, a millimetre. Don't round your spine, so reach your heart forward. Maybe walk your hands forward. Engage your legs. Top of your head forward. Three. Exhale. Two more breaths. Inhale. Belly in, shoulders back. Exhale. Last breath. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale right. Exhale. If you have a prop, come off your prop. Hands forward. So you're going to turn your heart towards the rear leg and place that hand forward. And inhale, so you raise your hips off the ground using your head. It's a bit of strength. So inhale, lift. Exhale, one. Just two breaths. So inhale. Exhale, lower. Just core strength. We're working somewhere here. So inhale, now turn to the other side. So you turn your chest towards the front of the mat. The other hand forward, most likely left hand. This time your feet raise. So inhale, feet up. Exhale, one. Inhale. So strong legs. Heart up, exhale, lower down. Okay, swap your hands. Turn your heart back to the rear leg. So if you struggle there, just do one of the previous ones, lift. We're going to try and lift and turn. So the intention will be to inhale, lift, turn one just 90 degrees and lower down. If you struggle with that, just lift, walk your feet, but maintain engagement in the core and the lower abdomen in. So inhale, lift, turn, 5 degrees, come down, or walk there. Exhale. Yes, I know, hard, perhaps, in time and practice, and now turn your hands the other way around. Take a breath. You're going to walk, perhaps, or inhale, lift, turn 180 degrees, exhale, lower. Bring your leg to the front. Done bust. Work in progress, right? Strength, core. We'll be doing that between asanas and strength poses. So here you stern them up, pubic bone down, thighs internally rotating, so your knees are to the ceiling, and the balls of your feet are forward. When it comes to one-legged reverse, three limbs forward, pulsa triangle mukha ekta pada paschimottanasana. So you're going to lean over to your left side and bend your right leg back. Your toes pointing back. If you find now that you're leaning over or you're struggling, sit on a block under the other sitting bone, maybe a blanket. So a little mirror image to you. So your right leg is bent. Bring your left hand out about 45 degrees. So you're helping to ground that right hip, so it's beside that ankle. If you have to be on top, you are with a block, or perhaps beside. Reach out, right hand towards your left foot. And gently grounding that left hip towards the floor, or maybe a forward fold. Three more breaths here. Don't allow your knee to open, we want it. Your knees together, or maybe a fist apart from your knees is fine. Last breath. Inhale, rise. Exhale, stay where you are. Come back to reclining pose here, working the front of your body. So maybe your hands, your elbows. You go back to all the way to the floor shortly if those are flexible. Just stay up here so you can see me. Moment, next asana, we'll go deeper perhaps. So just like when we're on our elbows and dolphin, we're opening the front of the body here, we're opening the front, hip quadricep, hip flexor. Most traditional yoga practices work mostly on hips, opening hips for our seated meditation poses. And this day and age, we sit in the car, on the couch, office chair, kitchen table, look out, trolling device, and we're all stolen forward. So these open the front of our bodies, it's therapeutic. So another breath here, inhale. Exhale, and inhale, rise. Lean over to your left and extend your right foot. The various ones in the previous classes I've done. Maybe just a little cross of the ankles, a bend, hands by your hips, and looking at your back and up. Inhale, exhale one, inhale, exhale two. Last breath, inhale, exhale, lowering down. Left leg. So lean over to your right, bend your left leg back. Bring your right hand forward about 45 degrees, helping to ground that hip slightly down. Any pain in the knee, come higher, come off the pose, blocks, two blocks, pillows, whatever you have. Dullness, it's fine. And in that left hand towards your right foot, in the pole. So move that left hip towards the floor, compression of that hip. In the front leg. Another breath. Exhale for five. Inhale, rise. Exhale, lean back. Elbows. Maybe it's just hands. Maybe sitting up here somewhere. That's fine. The practice of yoga is to go through as many things we can, the biomechanics of the human body, for the health and maintenance of this body and its life. So we can contemplate other things, other than sicknesses and injuries and disorders. Moving towards concentration and meditation. One breath. Inhale, rise. Left in. Exhale, cross your knees the other way, bend your knees slightly, hands by your hips, inhale, slide your hips back, and then up, belly down, straighten your arms, one, two more breaths, inhale, exhale, two, inhale, exhale, lowering down, and lean over to your left side, bend your right knee back. So bring your right leg back. Watch your mirror image of you, so you can, my left leg here. Bring your left ankle on top of your right knee. Press your hand out. Don't let the knee come forward. Raise that knee. And exhale, falling forward with the other hand. So weight is onto that left hand. Put your left knee up. The hip and foot, same as the previous asana. Down, or maybe you're sitting on your heel on a block. Couple more breaths. Last breath, inhale. Exhale. Inhale, rise. So keeping that foot on that knee can help ground that knee as we go to reclining pose, stretching the front of the body. Once again, you come onto your hands, onto your elbows here, perhaps your shoulders or back to the floor. Lengthen the rib and extend the front of the body. Five more breaths. Inhale. Exhale. So we spend our whole life forward folded. This psoas, hip flexor, it's short and tight, quadriceps, Jesus is very therapeutic. He's always preparing you for, perhaps at the end when you go back in, the mic goes, that's a little bit deeper than last time. Four, one more breath, inhale. Exhale, inhale, rise, elbows, rise. Straighten that leg, the left leg, open the right hip. Parayasana, so it's a twist from the fourth leg. So bring your left hand towards your knee. Five, raise your right hand and exhale. Reach, perhaps you break a toe. Twist here, maybe hold on to your knee or your thigh. Turn, look up under your armpit as you come into this twist. Pose here. Three more breaths. Inhale. Look under your armpit, perhaps. Your hand is up, that's fine. Just reaching, holding the big toe on. Bend the elbow towards the ceiling. Deepen of the twist. For four. One more breath. Inhale. One exhale. Look down. Rise, and then lean over to your side and extend. Lastly, roll onto the knees. Preparation for Balasana, Penta. Inhale. Exhale, fold. Lower leg, rock the rise for the first one. The upper heel towards your sitting bone. Inhale. Straighten your arms. Exhale. One look forward rather than down. Inhale. Exhale for two. Forward, inhale, exhale, lower it down. The other side. Now your left leg. Lean over to your right, bend your left leg back. Place your right ankle on top of your knee, perhaps. If that doesn't happen, it's here somewhere. We're still working it less. It helps. Hold that knee down. Also within the hip, so your left. Right hand out. Right side, left hand forward, fold forward, keep the knee off the ground here rather than down. Knees off the ground, reaching your heart forward. Look, that left hip towards the floor. Beside that left heel that's behind you or beside you. Three, two more breaths. Inhale. Exhale. Exhale, five. Inhale, rise. Once again, we're working on this in the front of the body, the shoulders. These muscles here in front. Come to your hands, and lift your heart to the ceiling, your elbows, your shoulders, your lower back, to the floor. Five breaths. Lengthen. Take your breath. Two, three more. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, exhale, four, last one, inhale, exhale, five, elbows lift, inhale, exhale, straighten out the top leg, push your right leg, open the left hip, Parayasana, push your right hand to your left knee, four more, five, raise the left hand, bend both elbows, that's available. Look under your arm. Maybe you're just reaching sideways here. Try not to let that sitting bone come off the ground too much. Instead of here, you'll ground that with your sitting bone rather than rolling over. Extending, lengthening. Four breaths. And exhale down, inhale, rise, breathing, extend. Cross your legs the other way around now, so the other leg on top, roll over your ankles, knees, so you want your knees narrow. Exhale, chest, belly, to thighs, inhale, lift. This one, the other leg on the ground, the other heel towards the backside, the sitting bone. Try and straighten your arms. Exhale, two, one more breath. Inhale, and exhaling. Some twist, another twist here. Raise, inhale, you bend your left leg. Place your right leg on top. Inhale. Raise your left hand, inhale. Exhale, hug the knee or elbow on the other side. Option to have the leg straight here. Twist, bend. Available, elbow on the outside. Nice and tall, inhale. Exhale, back. Three more breaths. Inhale. Exhale. Exhale. Last breath. Inhale tall. And exhale good. Inhale to the front. Exhale release. Cross the legs. Favorite leg on top. Malasana. Lifting everything up. Lift everything up. We need to hold belly and chest onto the thighs first. Suck, drawing belly, heels to the backside. Repeat one of those previous asanas or lift if you can. Inhale, exhale, one, look forward, heels up. Exhale, two, straighten your arms if that's available. Inhale, exhale, three, lowering down. The other side. So bring your left leg now. Right leg, left leg on top, the other side now, raise your right hand, exhale, elbow on the outside, inhale, reach half to the ceiling, and exhale, turn, shoulders towards your hips, reach, inhale, tall here, and exhale, deep in the twist. Last breath coming up. Inhale tall. Exhale deepen. Inhale look forward. Exhale release. I'm trying to put all that together. So if you've got blocks, perhaps use blocks. If you haven't got blocks, I saw a way. So-called easy way. So inhale, lift, cross legs, roll over, walk, step. Close, perhaps you might want to jump back and come back to Chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Bend knees. We did a jump last week, so you can jump here. For those who can go back to that video. Otherwise, one leg forward, the other extend. Parakonasana. Maybe some bikes. A little mat here. Fold your feet together. So sternum up, pubic bone down. Feel the tallness in the spine. You can hold your, interlace your fingers perhaps. You can hold your big toes. Or open your feet up like a book. Inhale, look forward, a meter or two. Exhale, reach your heart to that spot. So fold forward with a long spine. Shoulders back towards your hips. Heart reaching forward. Lengthen the back of your neck. So you're not overreaching your chin forward. Your chin is neutral. Belly's in. Shoulders back. Another breath. Inhale, rise. Those two. Here, tall. Now you're going to remove your top. Had one. Instead of extending the spine, I'm going to flex the spine. So now I'm going to cross through, tilt my lumbar spine, round my thoracic spine, my cervical spine, and gently roll forward. And I promise to the extension, a flexion in your spine. Don't force it. There's some effort, but it's a relaxing part of each asana. Last breath. Inhale, rise. Breathe in. Exhale. We've done a lot of opening the front. There's some shoulders earlier on in the dolphin pose. For those that did Pinchway Rasana. Well, help with the back bend. So if you come to back bends, inhale nice and tall, exhale into your back, bend your knees, feet at least hip width apart. Roll your thighs in. Draw that abdomen in, lower abdomen. Inhale, lift hips, push your feet into the floor, internally rotate thighs, lengthen both sides of your back. So although you lengthen the front, don't dump into your lower back. Lengthen your lower back as well. And opening the sacrum, internal rotation of the thighs, lengthen the back, a drawing of the belly in. Two more breaths. Last breath coming up. Inhale. And exhale, lowering down. Two more back bends. Repeat that two more times or go deeper. The options will be to bring your hands and lightly rest your head lightly, or coming up and extending both your hands and feet. Or repeat the previous one. So prepare. Looking straight one end and the other. Inhale, 5 breaths. Legs first, raise. Your head light, 5 breaths. Elbows in, not out. Elbows towards each other. Broaden your shoulders. 3, 2 more breaths. Last breath. Keep your chin to your chest, lower your shoulders, lower off the ground, and get lower down. Take a breath. One last back bend. You can sit it out, cut it up. You find you're clutching your lower back, really engage your belly, try to lengthen the back side of your back, of your torso, not just the front. So prepare. Last back bend. And inhale, legs, hands. 4 more breaths. 4 more breaths. Lifting your chest, lower your shoulders, lightly lower your back, hold your knees, lengthen 4 breaths, and then lightly bring your knees towards your chest. Another breath. Hands on your knees. Couple rock and rolls. Come to a fourth hold. Come into Pashya Muttanasana here. You can some height on your shin bones. Between your knees. Come to a fourth hold. 10 breaths. Listen to your breath. Last breath. Inhale. Exhale. Closing space. Inhale. Stick the shoulders down. Inversion. So exhale from onto your back. Inhale your feet to the ceiling. Exhale. Put your legs and hands to the knees. Relax your knees towards the floor, towards the armpits. Every week I've changed the sequence just slightly. You look at them all, you can possibly put them all together and create yourself a little 1:15, 1.5 hour practice if that's what you want to do. We'll just go back and review some of the little techniques like the jumps and four poles. Another breath here. Bring the soles of your feet together. Coming to sit the buttock of us. What I find here when you do this is a big arch in your lower back. lift your hips, tuck your tailbone under, lower your hips. Still a little arch there, you know, so an ant or a beetle, crawl under there, not like your pet cat or dog. That helps lengthen your lower back. Lift your head, lengthen the back of your neck and lower your head slightly. Bring a little bit of length and release from the spine. Relax your hips, slowly rotate your shoulders, biceps, forearms, arms.
When you see the most beautiful sight.
One more breath here. When you fold, inhale, draw your knees towards the ceiling, heel and toe your feet out. A lot of internal rotation of your thighs. You can lift and wiggle your hips, release your lower back as you internal rotate, and then relax and surrender to the floor. And so relax everything. There's possibly just a little rotation of your thighs in.
Think about it. There's me high down in the heart and the stars above. Without it, life is
wasted. Stay here for Shavasana, now resting. Nice and back, just release. Safe and internal rotation of your thighs. Perhaps placing a bolster under your knees. Or you can straighten your legs together or slightly apart. Hands by your waist or maybe out towards your wrist. Take an inhale through your nose. Open your mouth, gently exhale. Sigh, soft. One more time, inhale. Open your mouth and exhale. Flexing shoulders, flexing your hips. I'll be back in short. Resting, otherwise bring your attention to your hands and feet, bring some movement to hands and feet, toes, fingers. Raise your hands over your head for a stretch. Bring your knees into your chest. Twist them if you need a walk. Gently in your own time, come to a seated position, sitting up nice and tall. Seated position of your choice. And just to close, gently along. So keeping your hands together in prayer position, sitting up nice and tall. If you're joining in, wherever you are, take an exhale. Inhaling together. May all beings everywhere attain happiness, and all beings everywhere attain freedom. Namaste. Thank you again for having me in your lounge room again. By all means, remember to subscribe to the YouTube channel, and have a lovely day, and see you next time. Thank you.
Well done.